Thank you very much.
Dear friends, dear brothers and sisters, Tashi Dilei. His Holiness Dalai Lama has said that we are all part of one human family and we need to take care of each other. I believe he is right. Sometimes people ask me about my support for Tibet. As a part of the Tibetan community in exile, I have never been in Tibet in this life yet. Now, I feel it as my duty, as Buddhist and as human being, to be helpful for other people. We should feel compassion and concern about the Tibetan people that suffer already so long time and in such a very hard and inhuman way. I can't stand the injustice, the repression, the manipulations and the lies. Tibet has so much to offer to many people and even to humanity. Tibetan Buddhism and the rich Tibetan culture, for example, are such big treasures that should be preserved. And they should be practiced freely in Tibet. Respect for human rights is the key to a good, a much better and a happy life for the people of Tibet and for the Chinese citizens. It's also the key to a peaceful and a stable society in general. It's the key to better education for the Tibetan people, to good practice of Buddhism, of Falun Gong or other religions, without any control or limitations by the Chinese government. With respect for human rights, artists, journalists can exercise their profession and exploit their talents fully. Since March 2011, already 51 Tibetans have set themselves on fire publicly in Tibet. It's a desperate cry for more freedom, for the return of the spiritual leader, the Dalai Lama, to Tibet, and as a signal for a peaceful solution for the Tibetan issue to the world leaders, organizations such as United Nations and the international community. The peaceful demonstrations in Tibet in 2008 on the occasion of the Beijing Olympics always were forcibly and violently suppressed by the Chinese government. The repression has worsened ever since. Tibet nowadays is like a huge Chinese prison for Tibetans who are living there, with hundreds of thousands of Chinese soldiers and numerous police and checkpoints. Since March 2011, 51 self-immolations that were known. We have seen the very shocking pictures and videos of those self-immolations. In one word, horrible. It's almost unbelievable that in this 21st century, millions of people are still not free and still suffer from the lack of respect for human rights. Anyone should be free to express his opinion, to practice religion freely, to travel where he wants, and to have education in his own language. The global desire for freedom and democracy should also manifest in Tibet and China. If China really wants to play a major role in the world, first of all, basic human rights should be respected. The United Nations should send an independent observer to Tibet to determine the human rights violations and other abuses, and also the inhuman living conditions of the Tibetans, so that these can be condemned and resolved globally. The world leaders and bodies like the European Parliament and United Nations should take thorough measures for a peaceful and sustainable solution for Tibet and for stability and peace in the region. Today we all say, the injustice in Tibet must stop. The repression in Tibet must stop. The lies, manipulations by the Chinese government must stop. The lack of respect for human rights must stop. The arrests of innocent people and the tortures in prison must stop. The censorship by the Chinese authorities must stop. Today we all say, it's enough. It's more than enough. To the Tibetan people, I would like to say, we are with you. So don't lose hope, don't give up. Please stay together, help each other out, and continue the peaceful, non-violent struggle for freedom. Listen carefully to His Holiness' advices and keep the faith. The Dalai Lama is such a big inspiration for many, many people, not only for Tibetans and Buddhists, but for humanity in general. His ideas and advices go beyond nations, beyond nationalities, communities and religions. I would also like to ask the Tibet associations and human rights organizations to work closely together, to share information with each other and to support each other's actions. It's very meaningful to have a good understanding with respect for each other. I call upon all regional, national and international politicians and to the general public to learn about the real situation in Tibet and the suffering of this people. And please take action. Please support the non-violent struggle for peace and freedom in Tibet. Finally, I would like to say, let's keep the flame of truth burning. Let's keep the flame of truth alive until Tibet is free. Truth and justice will prevail. Long live Tibet. Long live His Holiness Dalai Lama. Free Tibet, free China, free Tibet.
Thank you, Mr. Denis Babian, for the very inspiring speech. And now I would like to request Mr. Vincent Matten, the executive director.